That I must thank ILBS for organizing this and inviting me to give a keynote address. I'm sorry I was called by High Court because of the pandemic situation here. They are monitoring COVID-19 situation in Jharkhand, and they time to time they ask for a personal appearance from Secretary of Health and Director of RIMS. So today was the day when from 2:15 I became free only just now. So I apologize for being late in joining. I must also thank Dr. Kapil, who has kindly extended invitation to whole of RIMS, as well as we on the other hand extended invitation to many hospitals and medical colleges in Jharkhand. And it is certainly an honor to be part of this national webinar. And needless to say that the right place for leadership for this type of activity is ILBS, and which I'm sure under the kind leadership of Dr. Sarin is going to take it up, not only at national but also international level. So in terms of the topic is I must say that is very close to our heart, because the ultimate outcome of whether it's hypertension, diabetes, smoking, or now non-alcoholic fatty liver disease comes up as an endpoint in the form of stroke, myocardial infarction, and in some cases with chronic vascular disease in the form of vascular dementia. So stroke and dementia, they are together constituting I think bulk of disease disability adjusted life years. More than 10%, in fact, which is a huge burden on health. And needless to mention that myocardial infarction is the number one cause of death practically everywhere, including in our country. So it's logical that we should try to find out how to prevent stroke and how to prevent myocardial infarction, how to prevent vascular dementia, which are the major contributors to disease burden all over the world, but also in India. And in fact, as we are transitioning demographically, which is our life expectancy is increasing, which was around 47 years at the time of independence, but it is now inching close to 65 years. So as we are aging, our demographic transition is accompanied by epidemiological transition, which is now non-communicable diseases are also contributing significantly to disease burden. Of course, this COVID-19 pandemic has attracted all our attention, and once again, communicable diseases are naturally in the top of our agenda, particularly COVID-19. But just before that, and when we are able to control COVID-19, you will find that majority of disease burden now in India, as well as in other developing countries, is because of non-communicable diseases. And non-communicable diseases are topped, as I said, by myocardial infarction, stroke, and dementia. So we have to prevent it. Prevention is better than cure. If once there is a stroke, it's a devastating outcome most of the time. And therefore, we have to prevent. To prevent these diseases, we need to know the risk factors and do what is called primordial prevention, if possible, which means risk factors do not develop. Primary prevention, which is if we control the risk factors, the disease may not occur, like nobody will have angina or TIA or stroke. But once they have stroke or TIA, then secondary prevention can take a role. And ultimately, if somebody has a stroke, and doesn't recover, we have to have tertiary prevention as well. So much better than secondary and tertiary prevention is primordial and primary prevention, which will not allow the disease to occur. So in that, you can say context, we have to know the risk factors at the very beginning. What are those risk factors? Why does anybody develop hypertension? Why can't we control hypertension? Why does anybody develop diabetes? Why can't we control it or prevent it? In fact, not control it, prevent it. So if we can prevent hypertension, diabetes, we can prevent smoking, we can prevent obesity, we will be able to prevent a lot of these diseases. And one of the risk factors which is now coming to light is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And as I was hearing, I think Dr. Duseja was speaking that we are now very, I think, regularly getting papers which suggest that it is not only an association, but an independent risk factor. So just for those who may be students or residents, you should realize that association can be alcoholic fatty liver disease. Patients are often obese. Often they have diabetes. So if there is diabetes, and diabetes is a risk factor for stroke, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease will automatically also appear as association with stroke or myocardial infarction. But that's not the case. Here, the literature is emerging or is practically already confirming that it is an independent risk factor. Even patients who don't have hypertension, don't have diabetes, don't have smoking, don't have obesity, if there is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, couple of diseases and stroke. So it's coming as an independent risk factor. That is why we need to study this much more and also find out why does it occur and how can we prevent it. So this will be one form of primordial prevention for cardiovascular disease if we are able to prevent non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So the question is, how can we know what are the reasons for this? And how can we prevent it? Now, I'm going to venture into how we are going to study this. But certainly, I would like to see a day when there will be enough knowledge for us to conduct randomized trials to treat fatty liver disease, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and show that treatment, which will obviously be controlling or maybe even managing or completely curing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It may be my wishful thinking, but it maybe someday it will happen. That will result in decrease in incidence of a stroke and myocardial infarction. If that is what we are able to show, that is when we have enough knowledge to prevent or do primordial prevention, which means we will not allow the risk factor to carry on or to continue so much that there will be stroke or myocardial infarction. In fact, we should be able to prevent non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So if we know either by genomics, which is to know who is at high risk of developing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and if that genomics can be translated into public health, and we are able to identify those at risk of developing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease by modifying their diet or changing their lifestyle because they are at higher risk, if we are able to prevent non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, that will be the real prevention and primordial prevention of preventing stroke or myocardial. So that's the goal, and that is why this is very important. It is not enough to just treat stroke. It is not enough to do angioplasty, stenting, primary, and so on. when all the damage has been done. The right time to start is to find out those who are at risk of developing risk factors, like one of them, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And I think that is where some kind of biomarker, it may be genomic biomarker, it may be some imaging biomarker of liver, for example, which will tell us at very early stage, maybe when people are going to school, that look here, these are the children who are at risk of developing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And therefore, we should be targeting to prevent development of this right from the childhood. That is the day we want to see, and I'm sure further research which will be conducted under the leadership of ILBS will take the journey towards preventing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. With this hope and my best wishes for successful outcome of all the efforts of ILBS, I thank you very much for listening to me and giving me a opportunity to speak to the august audience. Thank you.